Hi, my dear students. Welcome to Friendly Maths channel. In last video, we discussed about the pair of linear equations. Generally, a pair of linear equations attain three different properties. They are maybe intersecting, having a unique solution. They may be parallel, having no solution. And they may be coincident, having infinite solutions. We discussed already the why I shown with the using pens also. Then now what I said as law in the previous video, without using graph and solution, we have to know which type of lines are given by observing the coefficients. That is our today's topic. It's a very important topic. There is compulsory question. It may be short answer or long answer. You will get damn sure question. Otherwise, you will get at least one more of the two also. This is very, very important. A1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 represents a pair of linear equations. Then, by observing the coefficients, we can decide which type of lines are given. What are the conditions? Now, first, that a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Means what? The ratio of x coefficients is not equal to the ratio of y coefficients. Then these lines are intersecting. These lines are intersecting lines having unique solution. What is the condition? A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Means the ratio. Suppose I will give one example. X plus 2y is equal to 5. 3x minus y is equal to 1. Then what is the ratio of A1 by A2 and the ratio of x coefficients? A1 by A2 is equal to 1 by 2. B1 by B2 is equal to minus 2 by 1. Then a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Then we can say these are intersecting lines. Actually, when you are going to construct the graph of this pair of linear equations, then you will understand very clearly. But this is the algebraic way. If it is given for one mark of the 2 bit, you are doing such a big essay type solution, it's difficult. By observing the coefficients also, we can decide that which type of lines are given. Now a1 by a2, the ratio of x coefficients is not equal to ratio of y coefficients, then no need to bother about these constants. First you observe x coefficients ratio and y coefficients ratio, both are different, then you can decide that these lines are intersecting lines having unique solution. Then next condition, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2. A1 by a2 is nothing but the ratio of x coefficients, b1 by b2 is nothing but the ratio of y coefficients, and c1 by c2 is nothing but the ratio of constants. The ratio of x coefficients and y coefficients are equal. In last case, first you are observing x coefficient ratio, afterwards you are observing y coefficient ratio. If both are not equal, then there is no need to think about this constant. Those are intersecting lines. If both are equal, then you go with constants. Oh, sorry. Here the constant ratio is different from these two. These two are equal, x and y coefficient ratio. But constants are in different ratio. Then these type of lines are parallel lines. Lines are parallel lines. Parallel lines means what? There is no solution. No solution. What is the condition? The ratio of x coefficients is equal to ratio of y coefficients but not equal to the ratio of constants. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2. Here the one important point what we have to observe is, here both the constant must be in the same side. sometimes to get the confusion, one constant they will give this side and one constant they will give that side. Then you people are thinking and taking as it is, then it is wrong. The structure should be same, x term, y term, constant, x term, y term, constant. Otherwise constant that side. To get confusion, y term they are giving like this type, like that, they are jumbling. Then first we have to write in standard form, afterwards we have to observe. In the first case, x coefficient ratio is not equal to y coefficient ratio, intersecting lines. X coefficient ratio and y coefficient ratios are equal, but constant ratio is different, then such type of lines are parallel lines. And the third condition is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 and it is equal to c1 by c. Means all the ratios of x coefficients, y coefficients and constants are equal, then such lines are said to be coincident lines. Such lines are said to be coincident lines having infinite solutions. Having infinite solutions means the ratio of x coefficient, the ratio of y coefficients and ratio of constants also equal, then they are coincident lines having infinite solutions. These coincident lines are also said to be dependent linear equations. Dependent linear equations, as actually these are not two different equations. Suppose I will give one example. You see, 2x plus 3y is equal to 5, 4x plus 6y is equal to 10, means 2 by 4, a1 by a2 is equal to 2 by 4, b1 by b2 is equal to 3 by 6, which is nothing but 1 by 2, here also it is 1 by 2, c1 by c2 also 5 by 10, that is also equal to 1 by 2, means what, all these ratios are equal. What you observe here, these are not two. When you want to divide full equation with two, then you are getting the same equation. These are not two different equations actually. These are the same linear equations, one is the multiple of other. That's why these are called as dependent linear equations. Now, once again I will explain, a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0 represents a pair of linear equations. By observing the coefficients, we can decide which type of lines are given. First, we observe the ratio of x coefficients and ratio of y coefficients. If both are not equal, then no need to bother about the constants. They are intersecting lines having unique solution. X coefficients ratio and y coefficients ratios are equal, but constant ratios are different. Then those are said to be parallel lines having no solution. If all the ratios and x coefficient ratios, y coefficient ratios and constant ratios also equal, then they are said to be intersecting coincident lines having infinite solutions. These are also called as dependent linear equations. Let me explain this concept in simplest manner. This is the conditions we have to use. But what is meant by ratio? Ratio is different from quantity. Suppose one example I will say, suppose there are some floods or something, then a charity are offering some donations, then one organization want to give 50% salaries to the COVID-19 pandemic situation or something. Means what? It is half is the proportion. Everybody will give half salary, but the amounts are not same. Amounts means suppose I am getting 1 lakh, then I will give 50,000. I am getting 50,000, I will give 25,000. If I am getting 20, I will give 10. Means everybody's ratio is same. They are giving half of their salaries, but the amounts are different. Like that here also, it is not equal coefficients. The ratios are equal. Means what? Suppose you take AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 is one of the equation. Now, the first term is multiplying with the k, x term is multiplying with k. Then what is the ratio of these x coefficients? It will be 1 by k. And the second term is multiplying with n. Then what is the ratio? It is 1 by n. Then this type of, whatever the constant may be, it is c1 or k or whatever it is. Then such type of lines are said to be intersecting lines. Such type of lines are said to be intersecting lines. Means when x coefficient of one equation is multiplied by one numerical value and y coefficient is multiplied by another numerical value, then those two pair of linear equations are set to the intersecting lines. Suppose you take one example, 2x plus 5y is equal to 4. Then I am multiplying x coefficient with 3, then 6x. Y coefficient with 2, 10y. And constant with 1, then it is 4 only. Then a1 by a2 is 1 by 3, b1 by b2 is 1 by 2, 5 by 10. Then these two are not equal x coefficient ratio, those are intersecting lines. Means what? In the case of intersecting lines, x coefficient is going to be multiplied with one numerical value and y coefficient is going to be multiplied with another numerical value. Then you are getting the condition a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Now, I am going with another example. Now, same equation. Now, ax, by, c. Now, I am multiplying x coefficient with k and y coefficient also I am multiplying with k. But constant I am multiplying with some mc. Then what is the ratio of x coefficients? 1 by k. Ratio of y coefficient is also 1 by k. But the ratio of constant is 1 by m. Means what? a1 by a2 is not equal, is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2. Then such lines are said to be parallel lines. No solution. Means what? Here x and y coefficients are multiplying with the same numerical value, whereas constant is multiplying with another numerical value. Take an example, 3x minus y is equal to 12. Then I am taking one numerical value like 2. 2 threes are 6x minus 2y. But I don't want to multiply the same 2 here. Why? Means I want to give an example for parallel. That's why I am multiplying with some any another numerical value. It is 15. Then the ratio of x coefficients and y coefficients are equal but constants are different. This is the example for parallel lines. Now, coincident lines. What is coincident line? Now, both are multiplied different in previous, but in parallel lines, x and y coefficients are multiplied with same, constant we multiplied with different, but now in intersecting coincident lines, all the three we are multiplying with the same numerical value. Then, x coefficients ratio is 1 by k, y coefficients ratio is 1 by k and constant ratio also 1 by k. Then coincident lines having infinite solutions. Then you take an example. 2x plus y is equal to 4. Then I am taking 3 numerical value. 6x plus 3y is equal to 12. All the terms are multiplied. Suppose when I multiply, if I divide with 3 full equation, you are getting the same equation. No? Means entirely this equation is depending upon this. And this equation is depending upon that. That's why these type of lines are said to be dependent linear equations. Dependent linear equations. Last, one more, these lines are categorized into two parts. What are that, you know? Consistent linear equations. Consistent linear equations and inconsistent linear equations. Consistent linear equations means a pair of linear equations having solution. In that case, how many types are there? We have intersecting lines, unique solution, or coincident lines, infinite solutions. Intersecting lines, unique solution, or coincident lines, which are infinite solutions. These two types of lines are having solution. That's why these are said to be consistent linear equations. Inconsistent means what? Pair of linear equations does not have solution. What is the example for this? Those are parallel lines. Parallel lines which does not have any solution. Now, understood this video? Intersecting lines, parallel lines and coincident lines we can identify by observing the coefficients. If x coefficient ratio and y coefficient ratio both are different, they are intersecting lines having unique solution, which are said to be consistent linear equations. X coefficient ratio and Y coefficient ratio is same, but constant ratio is different. Then they are said to be parallel lines, which are said no solution. These are called inconsistent linear equations. If all the three coefficients are equal, ratios are equal, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, then those are coincident lines which are having infinite solutions. And very important bit, what are the examples of consistent linear equations? Means they may be intersecting or they may be coincident. Both are consistent, but inconsistent is having only one type of linear equation, which are parallel, does not have any solution. I hope everybody is clear with this concept. Actually, I want to do some problems, but the time is very lengthy. That's why I don't want to do any problems. Afterwards, after completion of full chapter, one of my students' notes I will upload you. Then you can search the problems. If any doubts are there, still you require, then you comment. We need some problems. Then I will explain some problems also in further videos. Next videos, be ready for solutions. How to solve linear equation. Now we discuss types of linear equations. Next coming video, solutions. What is a solution? How to find, how many types are there, and everything. Stay tuned to my channel and enrich your knowledge. Thank you.